Okay guys, this is a video I'm recording myself doing a KPI exercise here in Excel. Just to go through the formulas with you one more time for you to follow and being able to calculate actual market share, fair market share and so on, and to do a little analysis at the very end. So we have a comp set here of 10 hotels in total for the month of January 2020. Okay, therefore the days in the month are 31. We have the number of rooms available in each hotel, which is hotel number 185 rooms, hotel number 230, etc., etc. A total, we have 2,375 rooms in the entire comp set for these 10 hotels. Now, the occupancy is given here for each property as well, and as well as the ADR here at the end. Okay. First thing we're going to do is calculating the maximum availability in the entire month. So rooms 100 times 100. How do we do that? We are going to calculate the number of rooms that we have in each hotel times the days in the month. Okay, so 85 rooms times 31 days in the month of January. Then we have this formula here established and we can just drag it down until the end. So we can see that in the month of January, hotel number one has 2,635 rooms available to sell. Occupancy automatically appears because the formula is already set up. So we're going to multiply the total number of rooms available over the occupancy divided by 100 because I have set up this particular cell here without the percentage. So we can see that in the month of January, hotel number one had 1,907 rooms occupied. That obviously goes along. Now here at the bottom, we can first sum these up. Right, because we can always make a sum of rooms occupied as well as rooms available. And we can also sum revenue. Remember, for all the others, we have to do always a weighted average. Here, we do not need to sum up the number of days in a month because they're always 31 for each hotel. So we can just leave this empty. For the occupancy percentage, for the average for those 10 hotels, remember, we need to do a weighted average. So we need to calculate total number of rooms occupied divided by total number of rooms available, and you have a percentage here. So on average, 54%, 29 over these 10 hotels for the entire month of January. Okay. Now moving on, we're coming to the second part here, to the actual market share, fair market share, and then the comparison, which is the MPI, Market Penetration Index. Actual market share, remember, this is based on our occupancy. So how well are we doing compared to the total number of rooms that are available in the entire comp set. Sorry, the total number of rooms occupied in the entire comp set. How do we calculate that? We're just going to take the number of rooms occupied divided by total number of rooms occupied in the month. Make sure that you freeze this cell here. Okay, because it's going to be the same for all the hotels for the entire competition. Then we can just drag this down. We can see that the actual market share here is 0.048% for hotel number one, 0.044 for hotel number two, and so on. Now, the fair market share is again based on our capacity. Okay, so how many rooms do we have available? We're going to go again with the entire month. So total number of rooms that we have available in the month divided by total number of rooms available in the entire comp set. Again, make sure that we are freezing this cell since it's the same, and we can just drag it down until here. So hotel number one should have a fair market share of 0.036, hotel number two 0.055. okay, here I've decided to go with three decimals because the numbers have such a minor change, and I just want to be clear that I'm not missing anything. If I would only show two decimals, it would be too much of a drastic difference in actual and fair market share. Now for these two figures here, for actual market share and fair market share, as long as the overall average comes up to 1 or 100, here the sum is one, then we can be perfectly pleased with that here. It's exactly the same for those ones as here. You can see sum is one or average is 0.01, meaning we have done everything correctly. Okay, if there's a difference in number, if that would be 2 or 1.7, you'd have done something wrong in your figures here. So check your formula again. Now MPI, Market Penetration Index, we want to compare our occupancy with the capacity that we had. So our actual market share divided by the fair market share. Okay, gives us again the figure. We're going to work with the factor of one. So if we are equal in one, we are within line of competition. If we are below one, we are underperforming. If we are above one, we are overperforming or better than our competition in general. If you want to show it as a percentage, that's possible, but might be a bit confusing. For me, it's always easier to analyze the decimals. Okay, so we can drag this down here. Again, as well, as long as the average here is one, we have done everything correctly in the formulas, so we can be fine here. And that is basically the first part here, comparing our occupancy and our availability capacity to the rest of the competition. Now we can go here and look in the ADR. I would say we're first going to do the total revenue sales, because it's easier, so we can take our ADR times the rooms that we have occupied in the entire month to get the total revenue for the month of January. So here, hotel number one has 135,851 euros and 38 cents. We can then just drag this down to get the revenue for the rest of the hotels, and here at the bottom we're just going to do a sum, okay, to get the total revenue for the entire comp set, 3,124,230.76. So we can first do the RevPAR, if you like, to get that one out of the way. Remember, RevPAR can be calculated in two different ways, either ADR times occupancy percentage or our room revenue divided by all rooms that we had available. So we can just, for example, here go with total room revenue divided by total rooms available in the month of January, gives you 51.56 euros. If you want to compare this for the exact same hotel, but you want to go with ADR and occupancy percentage, that's fine. Just make sure that you put the percentage sign back here so it comes up as a percentage, and you can see the numbers are the same. So we're able to apply both formulas here. I can just add another line here if you like, and we can do it in both ways, whichever you prefer. So back to this one here again, this is room revenue over the entire rooms that we had available. Okay, so we can just drag this down, and if you want to do it here with the ADR, if that is easier for you, and the occupancy percentage, we can just do one more example like that. So we're using both formulas, if you will. And all the numbers are the same, so we have done it correctly. And, we can be happy here with our calculation, okay? Now, if we want to do the weighted average for the ADR, because we're going to need the average ADR for the comp set in a minute to do the ARI, we need to calculate total room revenue divided by number of rooms that we have occupied. Remember, weighted average is always total over total. So we know that the average ADR for the entire comp set here is 78.16 euros. For RevPAR, we're going to do exactly the same. Okay, we can do total revenue divided by total number of rooms available, or we can do the ADR times the occupancy percentage. Here it is already a percentage, so we don't need to do anything more, and we get the same result, 42.43 euros. Okay, now not to confuse ourselves more, I'm just going to hide this one here since it's the same figure. Now for the ARI, we need to compare our ADR to the rest of the competition, so average ADR of the competition. So we're going to do this cell over the entire comp set ADR. Again, make sure that we freeze the cells here, and then we can drag this down until the end. Again, as long as the average is one or close to one, we have done everything correctly here, we can be happy with that, right? And in the RGI, revenue generator index, again, there are two ways of calculating that. One that we've discussed in class, and another version that has been discussed in the STR report video that is shared on Moodle. I will show you both ways. At the end, again, we're going to come to the same conclusion, similar to when we are calculating RevPAR. Since we're here now just comparing how well the hotel has done in generating revenue overall compared to the competition. So we can either compare RevPAR, or we can just use the MPI and ARI that we just calculated. So if we're doing that, if we go with MPI times ARI, It's going to give us the rent generator index, very much similar to if we're calculating the RevPAR. We can use ADR times occupancy, and it's exactly the same. MPI, market penetration index, and REI, so average daily rate index. Okay, if you want to do it, if you want to go with our RevPAR, excuse me here, divided by the average RevPAR of the entire comp set, that is possible too. Again, make sure we freeze the cell here, and we are getting the same number. So it's the same end result, different ways of calculating it. Okay, as long as again the average is one or very much close to it, we've done everything correctly. We check ourselves to make sure that we don't have any problems in the formulas. Okay, and you see that you can calculate the RGI in two different ways as well. I'm just going to hide that one here as well, so we can focus on the comparison and analysis of these 10 hotels. Right, first thing we're going to do, we're going to check the MPI, market penetration index. We're only going to look at hotels that are performing above one, because there are other ones that are overperforming better than the rest of the competition. So best one here is hotel number one, hotel number six. Hotel seven is just one, so we're going to ignore it for now because we have others to focus on that are clearly above one. Okay, we're going to do the same now for Ari, average rate index. So we have hotel number three, hotel number seven, eight, and nine, and 10 as well, of course, although it's just a little bit less than the ones on top. And now for revenue generator index, hotel number one again is doing well, and then again seven, eight, and nine. Okay, perfect. Now we're going to try to find out who is obviously performing the best, at least in all three of them. So we can clearly see that hotel eight and nine are the ones performing best because they are in all three indexes above one. Now, who is the winner here? We're going to focus first on the revenue generator index. And here it's clearly hotel number eight is the winner because they are 1.78 in the index, meaning 78% above competition, which is quite good. Ari, not as high as hotel number seven, for example, but still fairly good, close to hotel number nine. But then again, the MPI, so the market penetration index, occupancy is doing really good. 85%, sorry, 58% over competition. So hotel eight is going to be our winner. Going to highlight it here in yellow. Hotel number nine is going to be the second one because again, RGI is 43% over competition. Still very, very good. Ari is a little bit less than hotel number eight, but very close. So the rates, you can see that as well here. They're very close. 88 euros, 14 cents, and 87 cents, 87 euros, 27 cents. MPI is quite lower, only 28% above competition, but still enough to make hotel number nine our number two in the entire competition. So I'm going to put it in orange. So these are our two top runners. Very well done. The hotels are a bit different because one hotel is 160 rooms, the other one is 265. So 105 rooms difference. Yeah, occupancy overall is quite different as well, but because one is bigger than the other, they are then able to compensate later on through the rate and then still achieve a fairly decent RevPAR and obviously revenue generator index. Now, who is the worst? Who is performing terrible here? We first again orientate ourselves with the RGI. And quite clearly, we can see hotel number four with 0.45 is the lowest of the lowest. So I'm going to put that in red for now. Ari, they're also below one, and MPI as well. There are others as well that are below one, but this one is clearly the loser because they're not generating enough revenue, right? 0.45%, 54%, excuse me, is not good enough here. So we're going to put that in red. We can also look into details. The hotel has 320 rooms. If you compare with hotel number nine, fairly close. Occupancy is terrible, 38%. Okay, they're supposed to achieve or try to achieve 9,920 room nights in the month of January. They have only generated 3,794. So you can see the difference here in the market penetration index, only 0.7 overall, not good. ADR as well is the lowest in the entire comp set, €59.60, which is why RE is very low and therefore RGI as well, right? And you can see the revenue as well. There are other hotels like Hotel 3, etc., making more money than them. So they need to clearly work on their occupancy as well as on their rate. Okay, I have put in the key here as well, just for you to see exactly the same results here that we have just achieved. That is basically the way for you to practice the KPI exercise. This should be very helpful for you for your project. If there are any other questions, I'm obviously available. So just send me an email. Thank you.